My name is Patsy Reid and I'm a Scottish fiddle player and teacher. I also consider myself to be a violinist, and over the years I've been interested in the different responses that I get when I describe myself as either a fiddle player or a violinist. And I suppose it comes down to the age-old question, what is the difference between a fiddle and a violin? Now, I must have been asked this a million times, and it's actually a fantastic question and quite a difficult one to answer. So, obviously, the instrument is the same. However, it is the repertoire that's played that makes it different. So, just as Bach is different to Beethoven, Mozart is different to Shetland music and Cape Breton music, or music from the Highlands of Scotland. So, although the challenges and the techniques involved are the same, it's actually the style and the repertoire that changes. So I am fascinated by this subject, and I'm delighted to have been asked to lead a day of workshops for the RNCM Junior Strings Project in association with the European String Teaching Association. And they believe that the techniques that I've developed as a fiddle player will be useful for their young students as well as string teachers. So without giving away the whole workshop in a video, I thought it might be quite good to show you one of the concepts that we'll be looking at, and this is string crossing. So I'll first of all play you a tune. It's called the Angus Buster, and it's a tune that I wrote, and I see this as it's a Scottish fiddle tune really, and it's got lots of string crossing. So I'll play it for you and then I'll talk a little bit about it. The Angus Buster, and you'll have noticed that I play that tune predominantly in the lower half of the bow, and that's a pretty common feature of my playing. There's a few reasons for it, and the biggest reason I think is because string crossing is a lot less labour intensive. So if I show you me crossing from the G string to the E string, in terms of getting from here to here, my finger is doing that whole movement. My shoulder is giving us the stroke, but I'm not going up and down. So if I show you the same thing in the middle of the bow, you can see that the bow's actually now shaking, and I'm also finding it much harder to not catch the other strings in the middle. And then you can see that when I'm at the tip, the tone isn't as good, and the bouncing, the control is even worse. And it's a tricky situation because a lot of people choose to play from either the middle of the bow to the tip because it's a lot lighter there. It's physics somehow, but if I put the bow down, I'm actually working less hard in this area of the bow. But when I come down here, I can feel the weight of the bow. So it's a bit of a catch-22. You make life easier for yourself in one way by playing here, but actually the challenges that you're faced with are much bigger. So I can show you a little bit of the tune again. If I play in the upper half, you can see how hard I'm working. It's actually really hard, and I'll just show you quickly that same B part at the heel. So little bit. Do I do it here? It's really hard. So that is actually one of the concepts that we'll be looking at. And if you would like to come to the workshop, there are still places available. Have a look at the European String Teaching Association website and you'll be able to get yourself booked up. The morning is for young players and the afternoon is a workshop for string teachers. So I hope you can make it, and thanks for watching. I'm Patsy Reid. Bye bye.